Hi folks, in this video I'm going to be talking to you about They Reminisce Over You by Pete Rock and CL Smooth, one of my favorite hip-hop tracks, an absolute masterpiece of sample-based production, and it's got quite an interesting backstory to it. It's the story of Trouble T. Roy, who was CL Smooth's cousin, who died young and tragically, and the song is really kind of an autobiographical picture of CL Smooth's own upbringing and just about overcoming adversity. I mean, a really inspiring and emotional and pretty vulnerable piece of storytelling. But I'm not going to be talking about any of that. I'm going to be talking about the production of the instrumental track, but it is remarkable to think about how serious this piece of music is and how frivolous its source material is. Specifically, the source material begins in a very improbable place with a Jefferson Airplane song from 1966 called Today. Let's listen.
Today, I feel like pleasing you more than before. Today, but I don't know what for. To be living for you is all I want to do. To be loving you, it'll all be there when my dreams come true.
I don't love Jefferson Airplane. I definitely don't love that song. The musicianship on it is pretty amateur level. That dude singing doesn't do much for me. Certainly, this is not a very likely starting point for a hip-hop classic. But so the following year, Tom Scott, who's a saxophonist and producer, did a cover of it. And the cover is certainly more professional, though also a sort of seemingly unpromising bit of source material for hip-hop. It's not totally uncharming, right? Tom Scott's got a beautiful saxophone tone, and it's sort of cool to hear his playing with the doo-doo backing vocals underneath it. It's got kind of a vibe, I guess. The difference between me and Pete Rock is that I would have heard that and been like, eh. Pete Rock heard it and thought, no, I think there's something here. I think there's potential. Specifically, a little bit later on in the track, when the energy level picks up, there's this. Okay, so maybe all the la-la-las are silly, but they sound good, and that one saxophone riff is really hot, right? Yeah, I mean, that's hot. Yeah, all right. Okay, so Pete Rock was not the first hip-hop producer to notice that sample or use it. Slick Rick used it in 1991 for It's a Boy, but he only used a couple of notes from it and as like a real background element. So here's this. I mean, that's kind of cool, but Pete Rock thought, you know, no, let's really use the whole riff and let's really like make it the foreground. And he also used a bunch of other little snippets of the Tom Scott track to create this whole kind of lush bed of sound. So here's They Reminisce Over You, TROY, by Pete Rock and CL Smooth from 1992.
I reminisce for a spell, or shall I say think back 22 years ago to keep it on track. The birth of a child on the 8th of October. A toast, but my granddaddy came sober. Count all the fingers and the toes, now I suppose you hope the little black boy grows. 18 years younger than my mama, but I really got beatings cause the girl loved drama. In single parenthood, there I stood.
A lot going on there. I'm going to skip ahead a little bit to the end of the first verse and into the hook.
Positive over negative for the woman, a master. Mother Queen's rising a chapter. Deja vu, tell you what I'm going to do when they reminisce over you, my God.
I mean, that is extraordinary, right? The song doesn't actually even have a chorus or a hook. It just has that saxophone riff with Pete Rock just kind of ad-libbing on top of it. You have to be pretty confident in a sample to use it as like the kind of musical centerpiece of the song in place of a chorus, yeah? But it works. So the Tom Scott samples are not the only aspects of the track. There's also that beat. And so the beat comes from the intro to Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud by James Brown from 1968. And I was pretty surprised when I first looked it up on who sampled, because I listened to this and was just like, this doesn't sound like They Reminisce Over You at all. I mean, that's an incredible track, and I'm sure you could pull some great samples out of it, but I don't hear They Reminisce Over You at all. And in fact, you know, James Brown is talking over a lot of that beat in the intro. Like, where did Pete Rock even get the drums from? But after listening to it more carefully, I noticed, all right, well, there's that snare drum hit without James Brown. There's that little kick drum, that little ghost note, and there's that hi-hat, and then there's that much louder kick without James Brown's vocal on it. And so, in fact, you know, there is a little bit to work with if you don't want James Brown going, with your bad self. Right? There's that. So clearly what Pete Rock did was just took these individual drum hits and loaded them on the MPC and then, like, played them back with his fingers out of order to create this very different sounding rhythm, and They Reminisce Over You. I mean, that is an extraordinary sample flip. Pete Rock, genius, yeah. And it's easier to hear his other production choices if you listen to the instrumental. I mean, CL Smooth lyrics are incredible, but yeah, let's listen without them, and you'll be able to hear all the different little pieces of the Tom Scott track that he took in addition to that main saxophone riff. Yeah, to me, like, the real art form of sampling is not just taking some recognizable and well-loved riff or beat and just looping it up and putting new music over it. I mean, I think that's, like, a cool thing when people do it. But what's more impressive to me is taking this piece of kind of pop cultural detritus, this lounge jazz cover of a silly Jefferson Airplane song, and finding within it the potential for a radically different, much more serious, much more kind of substantive piece of music. I mean, that really takes imagination to be able to hear the potential for a piece of existing music, right? To have that imagination as you're listening. Yeah, that to me is like the real craft of hip hop production. And it's a musical ability that I think is severely undervalued and one that really deserves more respect than it gets. So check out the link in the description for more about this track and about other songs that have sampled it. I made like a remix with all this material kind of seamlessly edited together. You might enjoy listening to that. Thank you very much for watching.